Hello everybody, today we're gonna play Smite, and today I want to show you about what to buy for mages like Poseidon and other gods. Okay. Well, starter things are salt, stone, because it gives a small 100% mana and 20 magical power. That's a good thing to start with because then you have more mana. Because all mages have something they can hit to, yeah, they can hit to first, and this thing is really good to buy first. And then I normally take this sometimes. That's a vampire shroud. It gives us the 20 magical power, 100 health, and 5 MPS, and killing an enemy restores 10 health and 10 more. So that's a good thing to start too. The next thing to buy is relics, and I have some. Yeah, then I have 4 things. Sanctuary, that does that you cannot be damaged in 2 seconds, but you cannot, but you can self. Not do anything, so you can't use your ultimate or anything, so it's really good to get away with. And this one is really good too, if you use those two after each other, it gives a really good combo. And this is sprint, so you will be quicker, and your teammates will be quicker too. This gun in the circle of what you do. Yeah. If you use things too, you can get away really. And that's good with the mage because then dark is so anyone can come and stun you, and that's just really annoying. So by damage we buy this one, Rod of Tahuti. It gives us 125 magical power at 50 MPS, and increases magical power by 25%. So if you want to be a damaging mage, this is a really good thing to buy. And then if you want a mage that can get life, yeah, because this thing gives us 12% magical life steal, so anytime you hurt an opponent, you get life, and it gives us 100 magical power too, so it's, you can be overpowered if you just buy these two already. And the passive is that you gain 1 additional magical power per 1% of your missing health. So if you haven't that much health, you get really much health. So the next thing we buy by damage is Kronos Content. It gives us 75 magical power and 25 MPS, and the 20% cooldown reduction. So all your abilities will be cooldown, yeah, will not be cooldown for so long as normally. So this is a really good thing if you want your abilities really quick. And defensive, this is a good thing because when you make, you need a lot of mana. Because if you have upgraded your abilities, they just cost more and more mana. Like Wukong is free if it's upgraded to 5, then it costs 150 mana. So if you want some mana and 50 bits per second and serves 200 health. The healing and its aura is the healing and regeneration of enemies within 55 units is reduced by 55. And this is magical. But if you want some good physical too, this one gives us the 90 physical protection and 200 mana. So it gives us more protection, but I think the other is better because it gives us more curve control and does a lot of other things. So yeah, but you can choose for yourself if this one is good for you. And then we have this one. It gives us 60 it gives us plus 60 physical protection, plus 60 magical protection, and 50% cooldown reduction. So this is a good thing if you're mage too, because if you have this one and this one, you can get 35 cooldown reduction, and then your abilities come gets really good. But the next thing we need to buy then is Bulwark of Hope. It gives us 60 magical protection, plus 200 health, and plus 20% crow control reduction. So this is a really good to buy too, because when you take damage and you can really heal yourself, but this thing gives us a shield when we don't have that much when we don't have that much health. This gives us a shield, and then we have more health, and then we can come away. So your mage, this is, I would say, the best magical thing you can buy, and that other thing you can buy too. And like here, a cool thing to buy too is this one for the mage, because it gives us 50 magical protection if you're against the mage. This is different, because it gives us 40 magical power and 50 magical protection, and its aura is reduce the magical protection of enemies within 55 units by 2. So you can also buy this one. It gives us 150 mana and 50 MPS and 100 magical power. That's good thing too. But this one, it's really good if you play a long game like Conquest. And if you play a long game like Conquest, this is a really good thing, and this is a really good thing as well. So then you can say to yourself, is it, if it's a good game, you can buy lots of power, but if it's a long game like Conquest or Clash can be a long game too, then as Warlock said, really good. So after that, we come to relic again. This relic blink, it's a teleport, and if you are hitting an enemy, you have 5 seconds before you can use it, and if you are being hit by an enemy, it's 5 seconds to use it. So if you want to surprise anyone, then this is a good thing. But it's a bit difficult to get away with it. Oh, I just forgot this one. Shoes of Magic. These are the, I would say, the best thing to start with, because it gives us 45 magical power, 10 magical penetration, and 80% movement speed. And that's a good thing to start with, because then you're quicker, you have some magical power, and you can have some magical penetration. And then we have Sunder. If you don't have any abilities and your opponent can get away with a jump or teleport or under the ground like Hades, then this one is good, because then you just can shoot this one and your opponent is dead. So this is a good thing if you want to kill an enemy with the last shot. And these, now we come to consumable. If it's a really long day in Gauss or free Gauss or arena or something, then this one is good. Elixir of power, it costs 3,000 like this one, but this consumable increases your magical and physical power by 25% in 5 minutes or until you are killed. So if you want to kill more gods, and if it's a long game, this one is a really good thing to use. And this one, if you are a guardian or something, it's a good thing too. But as a mage, it's good. Because if you don't want to die, then this helps you a bit not die. So this console will increase your mental and physical protection by 50 for 5 minutes or until you're killed. So these are really good to take, because then all the enemies who are up against, they surely got much magical and physical power, or magical and physical defense, but these two will help you to kill more enemies. That was it. But a thing more is that potions are good to start with too, because like this one, this consumable increases your magical power by 50 for 5 minutes or until you are killed. So this is a good thing too, because then in the start of the game you just can kill lots of enemies and maybe get first blood. And if you want to keep an eye on a place on the map but you cannot always be there, buy a sentry ward or a ward, because these can save. You can place them on a basic map and you can go to the battlefield, but then they can say if there is coming an enemy, like in the 3-3 Gauss. They're good because they can, if you set a group by Bull Demon King, then you can keep an eye on Bull Demon King, and then you know if there are enemies there, because if they kill Bull Demon King, their tower is dead. Your tower is dead. So, I hope you learned something about buying things to make it. And like I said before, you can decide for yourself if you want to be a really powerful mage, or a mage that is helping its teammates and can go a bit in the offensive. But I hope you learned something about this video.